So guys, let's start now. So I think the next topic we have is about the organization and its information flow. Okay. In this regard, we need to keep in mind that how the organization and when we discuss about the flow of the information always play a very, very crucial role. Whether it's, you could say, upward information, downward, horizontal, or we can say inward information flow as well. Okay. So when we discuss this particular diagram, as you can see that we are talking about definitely basically four type of information flow, which start from upward, downward, horizontal, and inward. Okay. Now, in this regards, we need to keep in mind that the first information flow, which will start now, as you can see in this diagram, the upward information flow, as it starts from the basic level or the ground level, moving to top level, downward information is going from top level to lower level. Horizontal information is passing from one department to other department at the same level. And inward information is basically all about the information within a department only. So very basic four information types, which we're going to cover up. Okay, so let's start with the very first part, that is right now about the upward information. Okay, so let's start now. So the basic directions of information flow. Okay. Now these basic directions start from the number one point, that includes your upward information flow. Now, as I told you, upward information flow is basically associated with information based on daily transactions. And these informations are basically starting from the lower level to the higher level. For example, suppose if you talk about the sales transaction in a company, sales transaction initiated from the lower level, reaching to the top, you could say the top level, in order to inform about the number of transaction which happens in a particular day. That actually comes under upward information. Okay. Now, in this basically upward information, as I told you, that is starting from the lowest level to next higher level. Not higher level, you can say. It is called the next higher level. Okay, so in this regard, we need to keep in mind that these information actually talks about the information granularity. If you can see this diagram right now, information granularity, it means that whenever any information which is being transferred or passed on from one you could say department to other department, or from one level to actually other level, as we know that the lower level management or lower level employees always must have the fine granularity. Okay, here the meaning of granularity, it means that the lower level department always need the information in much details. Okay, and in comparison with the upper level department. Okay, so you can see that there are basically two types of granularity which I mentioned right now. It is called the coarse granularity and fine granularity. It means that the top management do not need any information from the lower level department in terms of their decision making. And the lower level department always need the higher information set to work according to the system of the organization. So that is basically the part of your fine granularities and coarse granularities in terms of the upward information. Second point which comes under this category, that actually talks about the lower level, or you could say downward flow of the information. Now, downward flow of information, when we are talking right now, it actually definitely is originated from the higher level to the next lowest level, a lower level level. So it starts from higher level to next lower level. Okay, so that's an important point which we have, which comes under the next point, that is about the downward level of communication. Okay, now these type of communication is basically more about strategy based. These type of communication is more about, you could say, I could say giving the direction to the whole organization, and these particular you could say downward direction or downward communication is always talks about the strategies and the tactics which the company need to follow in terms of, you could say, giving the rights to you could say use the power, the position or the rights which is being provided by the top management to the other level of departments. Clear? Next one we have, that is about the horizontal information type. The point number three. So when we discuss about the horizontal information, it is basically between two business units, two functional units. It means that when the two departments belong to same, you could say cadre, belong to same level, when they are interacting with each other, that is called your horizontal. It is basically more about working in team. Working in team. So definitely here, the main important point is that whenever the different units of the organization are interacting with each other at the same level, that will be the part of your horizontal direction. Okay. Next part we have, that is about your outward or inward. Outward or inward communication pattern. Okay. So when we are discussing about the outward or inward communication pattern, this outward and inward communication pattern actually... yes, Shridevi, it's correct. Okay. So when we discuss about this particular outward communication, it is basically more associated with communication to your customer, to your supplier, distributor, to your channel partners. Okay, so all this will actually comes under outward or inward flow of communication, which is basically important for the operational activity in the organization. Okay, so as you can see that it is basically more about the operational level information, which actually talks about your customers. We can talk about your suppliers. We can also discuss about your distributors. So the communication between all those channel partners will be termed under outward or inward communication. Clear, guys? So you can see this diagram. Now you can understand this. The different type of information communication type. Upward, downward, inward, outward, or we can say that horizontal communication between two functional or more than two functional units. Clear? I'm unmuting everyone now, guys. If you have any query in this topic, do let me know, please. We can discuss. Raj, I hope so your net is working now.
Can you explain me that first point, that upward to downward?
Outward, upward and downward. Okay, fine. See, and we discuss about the upward and downward communication. First of all, upward communication starts from the top management to the lower level management. Okay. In this regard, we need to keep in mind that all the upward communication starting from lower level to top level, it is more about the operational level decision making. And when it's come to upward communication, it actually required more fine granularities. Granularities is nothing but whenever you need to take any decision at the lower level, you need to have some in-depth knowledge, in-depth, idea about company's policy in order to take a decision making. So decision making at the lower level part is required some fine granularities or the more upgraded knowledge for a particular individual. When we discuss about a downward communication, it is basically start from the top management to the lower level management. And it is basically more associated with strategy making, strategy implementation, tactics, plan implementation in the organization on reality or on the ground, we can say. Horizontal is basically between two departments, the same level, between two teams in the same level. And inward, outward is more about the operational level discussion with your customer, with your suppliers, and with your distributors in the organization.
Sir, I didn't got that horizontal way.
horizontal, shall I explain it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, for example, let's suppose you are working in a bank and the bank having at least 7 to 8 branches in your city. Okay, any communication between the same bank branches in the city regarding their transactions or flows, policies, whatsoever. So when the teams belong to same level are interacting with each other, that is called your horizontal communication.
Yes, sir, I got it.
Yeah, sure. Clear, guys, all this important point. This diagram is clear about the what is the fine granularities, coarse granularities, and all basic four important. Clear, guys?
Yes, sir.
Let's move to the next part. Now, there are basically four major important aspects of information sharing. And as we know that the information in different regards, because there are internal information, external information, objective information, and subjective information. Okay. So when I'm just talking about the next important point to discuss about from the perspective of the organization, how this information will play a crucial role in terms of decision making in the organization. Okay, so let's have a look, please. Now, when I'm just talking about information in terms of, you could say, types, when I'm talking right now, so there are basically four types of information we have, that is called your internal, external, objective, and subjective. Now, definitely this term seems very easy, but the meaning and explanation is very different when it's come to a utility of those information in reality. I think yesterday, remember, we discussed about data, information, and its collaboration. It all together a very different phenomena. Okay, so when I'm just talking about the internal information, what exactly we are talking right now? We are actually talking about the operational aspects of the company. Talking about the operational aspects of the company. When you discuss about the external information, we are talking about the environment surrounding. When we discuss about the objective information, it is basically something you can say which is quantifiable information. And subjective information, which actually talks about behavioral information. Okay, any example, I think, guys, we can define about the types of information. First is internal. What is about the operational aspects? Any idea to anyone, please? Any example, and with the help of your example, we can explain internal, external, objective, and subjective. Let me give an example to you, I think, and then you people can start, I think so. Let us suppose, for example, if a particular, you want to, you could say, have a loan, you want to, you could say, go for a car loan, okay, for your new purchase. And definitely the bank must need to decide upon that which particular customer is more suitable to give that particular loan to them. First of all, being a manager in the company, being the authoritarian, you could say, aspect in the company, the manager must need to understand about the operational aspect first. It means that they need to keep in mind how many customers are there, those who can act, to whom we have given the loan. Okay, what grounds we have given the loan, what were the, you could say, collateral which we have deposited. So any particular information access which is within the bank is called your internal information to give that particular loan to the customer. Second point is about the external information. Okay, external information is basically all about rate of interest to be charged, customer, you could say, paying capacity in the future. Okay, then about customer, you could say, credit score if you talk about. So external information is basically all associated with information which are basically associated with the, which are basically not internally available to the company, but the bank must need to analyze and ask for this information from the customer. Next important part is called your objective, or it is called quantifiable information. Objective information in terms of credit score, rate of interest, the amount of loan to be disbursed, when the EMI will start, the EMI amount, that is called your objective information that is known to you. Okay, try to understand, guys. Objective information which is known to you. Then we talk about behavioral information, which is called subjective information. It is basically something which you want to analyze. Behavioral is basically is all about attitude of your customer, the way he is approaching to the bank in this regard, the past behavior of the customer with other employees or other managers in the bank, we can say. So whenever I'm talking about the information access for a bank in order to give a car loan, these would be the way how a particular bank may access or may approach to that particular transaction.